this.
I miss Connor because she was really nice and she pushed me to get a good grade.
Mrs. Hammett, because
she's marked 234 plus papers just for me and Ellie this year. That's good, isn't it?
That's fantastic.
Thanks. Right, my favourite memory is when we were building the new furniture for the common room from IKEA and just building the tables, and it was really fun. I just sort of took charge and I don't know, I'm a IKEA buff, so it was just fun, you know. Yeah.
Miss Jones, because she's so lovely and she's a really, really good teacher, and when I first started doing English language she brought me out of my shell and made me realise I was actually quite good at it.
Miss Whitsey, because I've had her since year 7 and back when she was Miss Norris, and she changed my opinion on geography altogether. My favourite memory was creating my media videos and being James Bond for a few weeks. Everyone wants to be James Bond at some point.
My favourite teacher was Ellis because she's taught me for ages and she always gives me A's.
My favourite teacher is Mr. Loosemore because he has a cat called Velcro.
Hi, my favourite teacher is Miss Pace and Miss Ashwell and Miss Ellis because they're all lovely people and they have a lot of goodness. They're good eggs.
Miss Ellis and Miss Ashwell. Miss Ellis has taught us for 4 years and she's always there to help us with everything. And Miss Ashwell is just really funny and she's always got a funny story about like how her kids are high for stuff. And then there was one of my favourite memories is at Winter Ball. She was dancing to Single Ladies and then randomly she just stopped and was just like, but I have got a ring on.
My favourite teacher is Mr. Howell because he's smart, he's a good teacher and he has a impeccable music taste.
My favourite teacher is Miss Ellis.
My favourite teacher is Miss Stephenson because she's really funny, she makes me laugh.
My favourite teacher is Miss Ridge. She's just really funny. I don't love her. Miss Ridge. Karen Ridge. Ridge properly. Yes, I will. One of my favourite memories was when I got a selfie with Mr. Howell.
My favourite teacher is Mr. Blackett because he's got banter.
So my favourite teacher is Ms. Preece because she's my school mummy. So my favourite memory was when Mr. Fowler was on his
floor. My favourite teacher is Mr. Blackett.
Why is he your favourite teacher?
Have I got to say why? Jeffrey did.
He did.
Jeffrey, did you say what?
He said we have banter.
So, my favourite memory was when Mutter got kicked out of sixth form because he set a piece of paper on fire. Yeah, that was really funny and sad at the same time.
Ha! Got it!
And if Miss Ellis was 20 years younger, I would definitely.
No, shut up, get out.
Gone to fight the next door school. Every meteorites, born and raised. We are thick and thin till our last days. So hold me close and I'll surrender to your heart before the flame goes out tonight. Yeah, we'll live until we die. So come out, come out, come out. Won't you turn my soul into a raging fire? Come out, come out, come out. Till we lose control into a raging fire. Into a raging fire. Come out, come out, come out. Won't you turn my soul into a will give and time will take. All the memories made will wash away. Even though we've changed, I'm still here with you. If you listen close, you'll hear the sound of all the ghosts that bring us down. Hold on to what makes you feel. Don't let go, it's what makes you real. If the flame goes out tonight, yeah, we'll live until we die. So come out, come out, come out. Won't you turn my soul into a raging fire? Come out, come out, come out. Till we lose control into a raging fire. Into a behind. Let your heart be next to mine. Come out, come out, come out. Won't you turn my soul into a raging fire?
Year 13, I'm going to miss you loads. I remember when you all came and got your GCSE results in the library, and it only feels like yesterday, and I'm going to be absolutely gutted to see you go. And no, you don't say that about every year group, but your year group are quite special to me because you've been the first year that I was head of sixth form for and taking me through from year 12 all the way through to year 13. And I'm so, so proud of you all, and I want you to keep in touch, and I can't wait to listen to all the exciting stories that you've got to tell me. So good luck everybody, I'm going to miss you all lots.
I was blue and all I knew was I would never feel the same again. Yeah, what did she say next? Really? Well, I wouldn't worry about her, Donald. I mean, you're bound to win in November. No problem at all. Hillary Clinton's gone and forgotten. You just have to give me a minute, please, Donald. Could I phone you back, please? Because I'm just having another phone, a call through, okay? I'll phone you back in a few minutes.
Let's have a look. Who the hell's this?
Hello? Louise who? Louise Ellis. Hang on, that name rings a bell. Yeah, put her through. Louise, hello. Yes, Louise. Now, where are you calling? Oh, from Wrenn. Yes, I remember you. How's your lad doing? Daughter. Yeah, how's she doing? Okay, good. Fantastic. Great. Anyway, how can I help you, Louise? Year 13 are leaving. Well, about time. You want me to do a farewell message? Well, I could do that, yeah, but you do realise I charge for that sort of thing nowadays. Well, let's see. I suppose if you did your special, that would be £100. If you want to do your premium, that would be £50. And then there's £20 for the ordinary one. Well, the special one, well, I'd dress up for it, you know, silk dressing gown, you know, cigarette holder, glass of champagne, you know, soothing music in the background, you know, inspirational message, not a dry eye in the house, yeah, we could do that. Or for £50, well, the same sort of thing, but without the soothing music and no cigarette holder. Sets a better example, to be honest. Yeah. Okay, well, your £20 ordinary, well, yeah, to be honest, just for that, I would probably just tell them to get lost and make a rude gesture and tell them to get over it. But it went down quite well at Hatton when I did it for them. Okay, well, so what do you want? Okay, so, yeah, okay, money's a bit tight. Okay, well, I suppose I could just do you a basic one. I mean, I'll just do it here. I mean, oh, right, so the film crew are here already. Oh, okay, I wonder what they're doing here. Oh, yeah, there they are. Right, so you want some, I'll do it now. Okay, well, I hope it goes all right. Okay, cheers, good luck. So, year 13, hello, how are you? And farewell. I've been asked to do a farewell message for you. And I've been thinking back, 7 years you've been at Wrenn, 2009, and you probably trod gently and nervously into Broadway Hall, waved goodbye to your parents, sat down on the floor and waited for stuff to start. And I'm sure it's been full of ups and downs all the way through, and that's the way life goes, and certainly the way that school goes. But I hope you've enjoyed your time in the last 7 years of secondary education. And I hope, you know, you get your due rewards for all the hard work you've done over those last 7 years. So the first thing really to say, I suppose, is good luck for the next few weeks. Make sure you get whatever grades you need to go on to university or apprenticeship, whatever it is you want to do. Work hard. I often say to people, don't leave anything to chance. Revise every single corner of the syllabus. Don't go in there thinking, oh, I hope such and such doesn't crop up in the exam, because we all know it's going to. So revise hard, work hard. And as with so much in life, and I'm sure you've learnt this already, you get out what you put in. Yes, there are setbacks from time to time, but if you're prepared to work hard, you will do well, and that's true in your A-levels, and it's true whatever you do afterwards as well. So that's the first thing to say, good luck in your exams. The second thing, I hope you've been happy during your school lives. But I'm not one of these people that says your school lives are the happiest days of your lives. I think that's a bit depressing when people say that. It would suggest that your happiest days are behind you and it's all downhill from now on. Well, I hope that's not the case, and I hope for all of you, I hope you've enjoyed your school life, obviously, but I hope that your happiest days lie ahead of you. And the third, final thing to say is good luck with the rest of your lives. Remember, life isn't there to be endured, it's there to be enjoyed. So make the best of every single moment. Wake up in the morning and with a smile on your face and say, I'm going to make this the best day of my life. Live in the present, make the best use of the present, and the future will look after itself. So, all the very best. I'll be thinking about you when you're doing your A2s. Do the best for yourselves, do the best for your school, and all the very best for the future. Cheers.